on, give God a hand praise. In your circumstances, and it seems as though you have no man to lift you. Hallelujah. No man to lift you up past your troubles. No man to lift you up past your hurts. Oh, you know, many of you are hurting today. You may be looking good. You may have on your makeup. You may have your weave in. You may have on your pantyhose. Hallelujah. You may have your man by your side. But somebody is hurting on today. And sometimes there's a pain that all you need is someone to encourage you. But when you are hurting, sometimes you have no man to lift you. No man to speak a word of encouragement to you. No man, hallelujah, to help you to get past the pain of your hurt. Oh, hallelujah. You know you hurting because Jerry left you 10 years ago. Some of you are sitting here and you can't advance to your next season because you are held captive to your past. God is saying today that today you're going to be lifted so that you can move into your next dimension, into your new season. Say, it's my time, it's my turn, it's my season for God's purpose. I know God has a purpose for me, but I need someone to lift me. I don't know about you, but there are times I had money problems. And all I needed was my brother or my sister just to lift me financially. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Sometimes you may have kids problems. You have problems with your children. And all you need is a man, your brother and your sister. Because the Bible says that we are our brother's keeper. Well, if I am your keeper, why am I not able to keep you? When your season has come, and I know your season is here, why can't I help lift you to your new season? Because I know it's your time. I know it's your turn. I know it's your season. But I have nobody to lift me. We are brother's keeper. But my brother can't keep me because my brother needs somebody to lift him too. The Bible says that there were a multitude of impotent people. They were weak, meaning that they were not able. There was impotency in a man, means he has inadequate blood supply. There's not enough oxygen. Oxygen means spirit. Sometimes our brother and our sister are impotent because there's not enough spirit in their spirit. There's not enough God's breath, pneuma, in their spirit. There's not enough word in them to lift them above their circumstances. And because they are impotent, impotent people can't help nobody because impotent people are focused on their own impotency. They're focused on their own lack. They're focused on what they're going through. Weak people can't help nobody. Don't you know that the Bible says, ye who are strong, let him bear the infirmities of the weak. But if my brother's on the porch with me impotent, he can't lift me because he's in need of lifting himself. Oh, hallelujah. When I lost my first in 2002, I lost my pastor. At the age of 56, my pastor, my spiritual mentor, I lost my pastor in 2002. In 2003, March the 9th, my husband, at age 56, dropped in the church with a seizure during praise and worship. And at 11 o'clock, my life was fine. Hollywood, 11:15, my life had been turned upside down. I felt myself not having enough strength to get up. Hallelujah. I felt myself as though my whole world had collapsed and gone down to the floor. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? And do you know, hallelujah, sometimes God will cause your whole life to change so that he can reconstruct your life so that you may be everything that God has predestined for you to be. Sometimes we got to understand that there's a time and a season for every purpose under the heaven. The Bible says there's a time to get to keep and a time to give and a time to lose. There's a time to get and a time to lose. And sometimes we got to go through a season or a time of losing everything. So for the gospel's sake, so that God may reconstruct us. Does anybody know what I'm talking about today?